بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد Don't be fake about the genuine. Allah is true, the Nabi of Allah is true, Akhirat is true, Qabr is true, Hashr is true. That is genuine. Let us be real and also genuine and not be fake through the tongue only. Even though Allah Jalla Jalaluhu makes qadr of the fake. Like ulama explain, the magicians of Musa alayhi salatu wassalam, through their fake imitation, Allah gave them hidayat. Maulana Ali Asma used to say that jo hamare jo naqal hai, wo naqli hai, asli nahi hai. The movement of the jamaats, the harkat of the jamaats, it is fake. But he said through this fake naqal and harkat, Allah has caused a revolution in the world. Imagine if our naqal and harkat was genuine, what would have happened? So we shouldn't have this double standards. And let's start. Number one, double standards from the West, where they are saying that Muslims and Islam are oppressors, but it's the other way around. You people are the oppressors. Why? When a Muslim is oppressed, nobody says anything. When a Muslim is killed, nobody says anything. When there's acid attacks, countries are invaded, women and children, brutality, murders, where somebody's in parda, in hijab, and they targeted. You are saying your laws are of equality, but there's no equality at all because you've got laws dedicated according to what you want. And then you have laws now for counter-radicalization, but you are the radicals. So if we see all the rules that have been implemented now, whether it is Modi or Macron, they are making laws for Muslims. That's separatist values. It's a bigotry system. It is complete double standards. And they say we need to educate counter-radicalization. We need to educate people. What does it mean? You're going to have concentration camps. We need to get rid of this mindset. What does it mean? Genocide. What does it mean? The masjid is a place for this radicalization. We need to bulldoze your masajid. So yes, the fiqh and the books of fiqh, the action of one person is not justifiable. One person beheaded somebody is not justified in Shariat. But why are you using it as an excuse for surveillance, for monitoring, for tracking, for implementing rules and regulations which are more an oppression against Islam? It is not helping Islam. It is an oppression. You call us names, but the truth is that you have all the flaws. Prejudice is from you, bias is from you, discrimination, unfairness, injustice, narrow-mindedness, fanaticism, racism, racialism, everything is emanating from you. Let's not forget and go back in history. Over 100 years, 1830 to 1962, when the French army invaded Algeria and they instituted camps for Muslims and they constructed barriers to limit the Muslims, electric fences, barbed wires, over 320 kilometers stretched to the Tunisian border. Millions of Algerians were removed from their villages in the mountainous areas, and they were resettled in concentration camps. If there was ever a greater zalim, that is you. You tortured, you raped, you murdered innocent people. When Algeria was colonized, they say 2 million people were displaced, starved, and suffered the consequences of the invasion. And those same people that you made slaves and they came back to France and you utilized, you wiped out their generations and you utilized their potential, and now you are still saying that you want equality? There's no equality. Let's look at Macron. He was a 15-year-old boy and he had an affair with a married woman. This is in a biography book of the French president. And the teacher was 24 years senior to him, 39 years old, a mother who had three children. And the parents were shocked of this illicit affair. And when the parents told the lady to stay far from their son, she said she cannot promise anything. And he later went on to marry the school teacher. When he was 29, she was 54 years of age. So if you are talking about double standards, then you have double standards. People are saying freedom of speech. Freedom of speech are for people who are in the minority and can say something about the majority and don't have oppressive. They're saying over 70 masajid were closed because we're not going by the tune, we're not playing your tune. Charity institutes, those institutes were there to serve humanity, you have shut them down. People have been arrested. You are saying freedom of speech? These very people cannot speak freely, yet a person who is causing so much zulm and oppression and laying accusations and words on Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you say in radicalization, whereas you are the cause. We say in the books of fiqh, it does not justify it. But look at the cause. Who's causing the trouble? The French have said, we are for liberty, equality and fraternity. What liberty? When you don't do, you can't even do good. People want to worship their creator. You can't even do that. You say equality when you have your own set of rules. You say fraternity when you're treating people differently. So why are the Muslims being targeted specifically? And they're using in the name of radicalization, we're solving this problem. You're not solving any problem. So if there is double standards are from you, number one. Number two, as people of Iman, we need to see, do we have our own double standards before we point a finger at somebody else? Three fingers are pointing at me. Like the Shaykh says, Dawa hai ashika, lekin amal hai fasika. You say, you proclaim love, but your actions are contrary. Maulana Abdul Hamid Sahib, Damat Barakatum, always used to say, we are we Muslims on the outside, but Yankee inside. Maulana Farooq Sahib Makki says, if there are a situation where people and there's dead bodies between Muslims and Kafirs, then the angels will come and will be confused. Which bodies do we take? We cannot recognize the people of Iman. Maulana Ismail used to say there are three types of irtidad. One is amali, where externally our actions are exactly like a kafir. So we need pointing fingers at them. You need to point it at ourselves. He said secondly, qalbi, where the heart's ambition, focus, desire, target in life is exactly like a kafir. He said, when you see these two happen in the ummah, there's the last one that's left is irtidad lisani, where with the tongue, na'udhu billah, Allah save us and save our generations and save the ummah, where a person says on his tongue, I am no more a Muslim. And we are getting cases on an ongoing basis from religious pious homes. Because the children of today are no more our children. They're not our children. They are orphans. They are orphans to social media. They are kids without parents. And let's check our double standards. When we celebrate, do we celebrate day occasions? On birthdays, are we particular? Anniversaries, Christmas, New Year celebrations, baby showers, bachelor parties, all these occasions which Batil is celebrating, am I also part of it? Is our lifestyle the same like Batil, or do we eat like Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was a abd, a humble servant who used to eat on the floor in the same plate sharing. When we build our houses, our toilets, low toilets or high toilets, is our nose gone so high? Are we more particular about the toothbrush than the miswak? The name of the child, does it sound more better when it's closer to French or closer to the English celebrity name or closer to Ambiya and Sahaba? Am I giving more priority to secular education rather than Islamic education? When somebody looks at our children, are they reminded of Mickey Mouse, Louis Vuitton, the enemies of Allah, or Talha, Zubair, Saad? If we need to boycott, we need to boycott their fashion, their catwalks, their interest systems, their Hollywoods, their Bollywoods, their celebrities. We need to go back 1400 years in time and come to Sirat Mustaqim. Come to the way which Nabi alayhi salatu, that same thing which we're fighting for, we've abandoned. Maulana Yusufun Arhlali say, if the Muslims only did business the Islamic way, half the world, if not more, would have already been Muslim. Maulana Sayyid Khan Sahib would say, aaj haq aur batil mein muqabla nahi ho raha hai. There is no opposition, there is no war, there is no confrontation between haq and batil today. Aaj batil aur batil. Batil is fighting batil. Wo bade batil hai, hum chote batil hai. They are the big batil. We are the small batil. And Maulana went into detail. If Allah gives us tawfiq, we'll mention that again. They are the big batil. We are the small batil. Aur usul hai. Batil walo apne batil mein khalis hai. Aur haq walo, the people of batil are pure, sincere, genuine in their batil. And the people of Haq are contaminated. He said it's an usul that the pure will always overpower the contaminated. So we need to check again double standards. Am I also laying claim to something which I have fallen folly for? I've fallen in the trap. The number three, that whatever they're saying and they're taunting, Allah will sort them out. يَسْأَلُونُكَ عَنِ الشَّهْرِ الْحَرَامِ. A delegation was sent, they were given a responsibility. So in that expedition, some people were not supposed to be killed, they were killed in the month, which is a forbidden and a sacred month. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that, yes, it is the sacred month, but والفتنة أكبر من القتل. That fitna is worse. They might have done something wrong, but the fitna that you are causing, and what is fitna? ولا يزالون يقاتلونكم حتى يردوكم عن دينكم. Until they take you away from your deen. That's a bigger fitna. So don't ever compromise on deen. They will latch onto one occasion, they will make propaganda, they will use it against you. Don't fall prey to their plotting. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took responsibility that Allah will suffice against the mockers. كَفَيْنَاكَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ. We will suffice for you, for everybody that is mocking. Do not fear them, because Allah will protect you. Like other ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاللَّهُ يَعْصِمُكَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Don't worry, Allah will protect you. إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرِ. If they want to degrade you in dunya, don't worry. Let them see degradation. And let them see disgrace in akhirat. So proclaim what you need to do. Do what you have to do. Muhammad bin Ishaq says there were five mockers. Go into tarikh, see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did with them and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala terminated them. فَاسْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ وَعَارِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Do what you need to do. Do your, fulfill your responsibility. Don't waste your time and energy. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a responsibility. Now we do not need to give them more fuel. وَأَحْسِنْ إِلَىٰ مَنْ أَسَىٰ إِلَيْكَ. If we have to get this good character of Janab Elias Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Taif he was pelted, he had an option, he didn't exercise it. Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul was the leader of the Munafiqeen. Nabi alayhi salatu was salam read his salatul janaza, he gave his garment. Although he was the leader of the Munafiqeen, he humiliated the Nabi of Allah. He prevented the development of Deen and Islam. He casted aspersions and doubts in people. He tried to destroy the unity and solidarity. So much yet. And then if we're going to boycott, no problem, we're not speaking against it. Do what needs to be done. But how long? In which products? And why are we selective? Boycott all of it. And what about China and the Uyghurs? What about Israel, the Palestinians? And the list goes on and on and on. If you're going to do it properly. Somebody will say, okay, do it half-heartedly. Then what about the Muslim countries? And the question is, why are we dependent on their products in the first place? And why don't we support our own Muslim brothers? So we are making a da'wah of the love of Nubuwa, but it's same thing. But we're not ready to sacrifice. We're not ready to follow what should be done and abandon what needs to be abandoned. We have to abandon sin, abandon ma'asiyat, abandon their way of life. So like a person makes nikah and they tell a person, you know what, we're in love and we're going to get married and actual nikah is to find Allah, but the nikah, there's no love, there's no deen, it's become a routine. So deen has become like that. So it's a deception, it's a lie, we live in a deception and we need to get out of it. This is your wife woke up in the middle of the night, she heard her husband crying uncontrollably, so she went quickly downstairs to investigate and said, oh my darling, oh my husband, what's wrong? He said, you know, remember 20 years ago I got you engaged and when we started our relationship, I met your father and he said, you know what, you are going out with my daughter, you need to marry her. So she says, yeah, I remember. He said, well, when your father threatened me, he said, I'll throw you in jail. I'll throw you in jail. He said, it's 20 years now. I would have been released tonight. I would have been released tonight. So superficial. Everything is superficial. You say marriage is what? In the first year of marriage, the man speaks and the woman listens. In the second year, the woman speaks and the man listens. In the third year, they both speak and the neighbors listen. In the fourth year, the lawyers speak and the judges, the judge listens. The lawyers speak and the judge listens. Somebody asked the man about description of marriage. So he said, it's a very expensive way of getting your laundry done for free. Everything is superficial nowadays. Someone asked a person that, how do you know this time this is the love of your life? He says, a person knows he's in love when he loses interest in his cars. I've lost interest in my cars. Somebody's credit card was stolen, but he didn't report it. So his friend asked him, why didn't you report it? He said, the thief was spending less than my wife. The thief was spending less than my wife. So I am, they say it's the shortest sentence in English language, I do is the longest. Why? Because nikah is just a formality now. We say it's a torture, it's a torment. They say marriage is an institution in which a man loses his bachelor's degree and a woman gets her master's. A son asks his father, how much does it cost to get married? He says, I don't know, I'm still paying for it. So that's we're supposed to have barakah, khair, Allah's ma'iyat. Somebody said, my wife's an angel. So the other man said, you're lucky. My wife is still alive. My wife is still alive. Somebody used to call his wife by nickname Sugar Lum, Kitten, Honey. So his friends were very impressed. They thought, this couple, they've got it made. So they said, you know, your marriage must be proper, 100%. We admire you. So he said, actually, I'm getting old 3 years ago. I forgot my wife's name 3 years ago. The amal for today is that the Masturat came to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam and requested that the men go in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they get all the rewards. What's for us? So he replied, O kama qal ablighi man laqiti min an-nisa, inform the woman. أَنَّ طَاعَةَ الزَّوْجِ وَإِتِرَافًا بِحَقِّهِ Obey your husbands, acknowledge it. That is equivalent to all the sacrifices the men make. يَعْدِلُ ذَلِكَ وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْكُنَّ مَنْ يَفْعَلُهُ But very few of you will do it. May Allah give us tawfiq of making amal. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ